In this video, we will study about Content Delivery Network, or in short, CDN. These are also called Content Distribution Networks. So let's see what is a CDN. So this diagram beautifully illustrates this. So let's say you have a website and whose server is located here. So this is the main server. This is your server. And your site has become popular and you are getting requests from all around the world. For example, here from UK, from Australia, from India, from southern part of America and Asia as well. So you see that if all the requests are coming to your main server, then this server will have a huge load since the number of requests is very large. And also you see that the requests coming from these nearer part, these will be served very quickly, but those requests which are coming from a long distance, there will be some latency. So it needs some time to request for reaching here and then in turn returning the content. So in such cases we use CDNs, and in this diagram you can see CDNs. These are the CDN networks. So let me draw in, this is a CDN, let's call it C1, C2, C3. For simplicity, let's assume that there is just three CDN networks here, and you see that all of them are interacting with the main server, and this one also. So when a request comes from a client located in this part, these are clients, then it will be served by this CDN instead of the request going to the main server. Similarly, if a request is coming from this part, then the nearest server will be this CDN. So CDN are acting as proxy servers. They are not actual servers, but they are proxy servers acting on behalf of the main server. And they are globally distributed so that whenever a request comes, the request will be served from CDN server that is nearest to the user. And these are generally used for static files. That is the files which are not changing, or these are same for all the users. For example, if you try to view the site having some image, some text, then it will be common to all the clients. It will be irrespective of which user has logged into that, which user is browsing it. So these are mainly used for static content like images, videos, HTML or JS or CSS files. Then when I request amazon.com, and similarly some other user request amazon.com in totally different part of the world, let's say here, why its request is getting routed to this one whereas my request is getting routed to some other CDN, maybe this one. So this whenever we request for any website, domain name resolution takes place. And if you don't know how this DNS resolution takes place, don't forget to check my previous video, which was on domain name servers. So how domain name system works. So when a client requests for a site, then with the DNS resolution, it will be provided the IP address of this server instead of the main server. So the request will be made to this IP address. So this is how CDN works. Now we directly see some of the obvious advantages of CDN. So let's look at some more advantages of CDN. So first advantage, as we clearly can see, is performance benefit. How? Because users receive content at data centers which are closer to them. So closer server serving the request instead of going it to remote servers, and this also puts less load on your main server. So this also improves the performance, and as a result of this, if much less load is coming to your server, only the CDNs are interacting with it in order to get some new content. The content may have expired, or you have set some TTL, or the content may have been updated, so it needs to be updated in these CDNs as well. So only those CDNs are interacting with the main server, so that reduces the load as well as the downtime of your server. Apart from these obvious benefits, there is another main benefit for which CDNs are highly used. Even if your site is not that popular, not that many requests are coming, still we should use CDNs because these add an extra layer of security. All the CDN providers, for example, you may have CDN from Amazon, Akamai, or some other company like Rackspace, and there are many more, and they have different services that they provide, and they have different plans based on the services they are providing. So one of the main uses is that they add an extra firewall security. So you see that instead of requests going directly to your server where the hacker may hack on your system and may do various things to it, the requests are going to CDNs and the content is fetched from here, and these CDNs can also detect any attempt to hack the system, or even if they are hacked, it puts less stress on your server and it still remains safe. And these CDNs are so advanced that they not only detect incoming malicious activities, but they also see that if while fetching data from the main server, they can also detect outgoing malicious content as well. So these are some of the main advantages of using CDNs. Now let's see what are the different types of CDNs. So mainly we will categorize it into push CDNs and pull CDNs. So let's see what is the difference between these. So push CDNs receive new content whenever changes occur on your server. So you take the responsibility of providing the content, uploading directly to the CDN and rewriting the URLs to point to the CDN. So it's on your side, the main responsibility. And you can configure when content expires and when it is updated. So when should we use push CDNs? So it's mainly suitable for sites with small amount of traffic or sites with content that is of that is not often updated. So it should be not here, that is not often updated, then in those cases push CDNs are favorable. Similarly, let's look at pull CDNs. So here the CDNs will fetch new content from your server instead of you providing the content yourself. So these will fetch new content from your server, and when first user requests the content, so let's say this is the CDN and this is the main server, and an user requests for one image, let's say, or visits to a one of the pages of a site where image one was required and it was not present on this CDN, this pull CDN, then the first time a user requests it, it will be fetched from your main server and then it will be cached here. So subsequent request will be faster, but the first request that comes for a particular image or a video, then there may be some lag there. And a time to live can determine how long content is cached. So you can configure this, and pull CDNs minimize storage space on the CDN but can create redundant traffic if the file expires and are pulled before they have actually changed. So even before changing, it has expired and you pull that again, so it creates extra traffic, but it requires less storage on this system. And when should we use pull CDNs? So here it's preferred when sites have heavy traffic. So as the traffic is spread out more evenly with only recent requested content remaining on the CDNs. So the most recently requested resources will be on the CDN, otherwise it will not be. So now let's look at some of the disadvantages. One is obviously that you will need to pay some price to the CDN service providers, although this is not too costly considering the benefits. These are very nominal charges, and there is a possibility of stale content. Content might be stale if it is updated before TTL expires it. So TTL has not expired, but before that the content was changed. So stale content is lying on the CDN cache, so it may serve a stale content to the user, and it requires changing URLs for static content to point to the CDN. So these are some of the disadvantages. So I hope you will take advantage of content delivery networks whenever you are building your websites.